If you've ever used vector graphic software like Adobe Illustrator or Adobe Animate, you're probably familiar with the curve line tool. You've already worked with these things known as Bezier curves. Even if you've used video editing software like Premiere Pro, you might know about Bezier animations. These curves are used to create smooth lines between a set of points, and the math behind them is really neat. Say you're given two points. How would you construct a curve between them? Most of you might intuitively want to draw a line like this, and while that's fine, even a straight line between the points could be considered a curve. This changes when we add a third point. Most people would draw a curve like this, something that would be more comparable to an interpolation between the points. Here is how a Bezier curve created using three points would look. The curve simply uses these control points as guides for constructing the curve, with only the start and end points being part of the curve itself. Here's one you might be more familiar with. A Bezier curve between four points. It's the same one you use to manipulate lines in vector graphic software. Each of these curves has a different degree associated with it, and visually, this degree determines the number of direction changes possible in the curve. A linear Bezier curve is simply a straight line. It has a degree of 1 and 0 directional changes. A quadratic Bezier curve has a degree of 2 and can have at most a single direction change. Similarly, a cubic Bezier curve can have 2 direction changes. If you want to generalize, a d-degree Bezier curve is defined by d plus 1 control points and can have a maximum of d minus 1 directional changes. Alright, the big question. How do Bezier curves work? They're essentially just a bunch of linear interpolations put together. What are linear interpolations? They're basically a way of constructing a straight line between points. Let's create a variable and call it t. T will have a value between 0 and 1, which you can think of as a percentage, representing how far into the line the interpolation is. At t equals 0, it's just starting. It's equal to the first point. At t equals 0.25, you're about a quarter of the way through the line. T equals 0.5 represents halfway through the interpolation, and t equals 1 is where the interpolation ends. It's equal to the last point. A first degree Bezier curve is the same as a linear interpolation between two points. But let's tackle something a bit more interesting. What's the logic behind creating a quadratic Bezier curve? All you need to do is take the linear interpolation of the linear interpolation. What does this mean? Let's start our parameter t at 0 again. Every time t increases, we will linearly interpolate between the first and second point, and the second and last point. So in the end, we get a shape like this. Now, what if every time t increases, we also form a linear interpolation between the two points that we got? Something like this. Doing this for every value of t will form a smooth Bezier curve. Let's try applying the same logic to a Bezier curve with another control point added. For simplicity's sake, I've set the value of t to 0.5, which means that all the linear interpolations we form will be about 50% complete. Let's start by creating the first layer of these interpolations. You'll notice that we are now left with one fewer point than what we had before. We can repeat this process, being left with one fewer point every time, until we're left with just a single point. Creating a linear interpolation between the three points gives us the second layer of interpolations, and we are now left with two points, which we can interpolate between again until we get the value of the Bezier curve at t equals 0.5. Putting together these values for every value of t will give you a cubic Bezier curve. This is a principle that applies to any number of control points. Form the first layer of linear interpolations, interpolate between that first layer to form a second layer, and keep doing that for every layer after until you only have one point left. And that about covers it for this video. I hope it's helped you understand Bezier curves, what they are, what they do, and how they work. If you have any questions, post them in the comment section and I'll try responding as quick as I can. I'm planning to release another video that delves a bit deeper and explains the mathematics of these curves, so make sure to keep an eye out for that.